Hey guys, Joe back again, another episode of Getting Junk Done. Today I got a chemistry video for you. We're going to be talking about temperature scales. We're going to define the big three that you might see in science class and how to convert from one to the other. All right, let's get started. First one is Celsius. The second one is Kelvin. Finally, Fahrenheit. Fahrenheit's kind of the odd man out here. It's not necessarily used all that much in science, but it is used. It does have some scientific applications, but for the most part, the United States is one of the very, very few places that rely on Fahrenheit on a day-to-day basis. The rest of the world looks at Celsius. So if you live in a part of the world where you use Celsius, this video might already be second nature to you. But if you've never heard of Celsius or Kelvin, you're going to have to put a little bit more work into this. But the big three you're going to see, Celsius, Kelvin, and Fahrenheit. Celsius is abbreviated as degrees Celsius. Kelvin is abbreviated as K. There are no degrees in Kelvin. You just say Kelvin. Fahrenheit is abbreviated as degrees Fahrenheit. First one up is Celsius. Celsius is based on water. They looked at water and said, when water melts, we're going to make that 0 degrees Celsius. When water boils, we're going to make that 100 degrees Celsius. The difference in between, they broke up into 100 parts, and that defined the size of a degree. The size of a degree Celsius is very important and will play a role in the development of the Kelvin scale. And we're going to show that on the next slide. Now, Kelvin is based on absolute zero and intertwined with the idea of kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is the energy that something has while it's moving, or the energy that something has while in motion. Now, if you look around, everything that you see around you is made up of stuff. That stuff is actually atoms and molecules and things like that. If you were to zoom in at the atomic and molecular level, you will see that everything, in fact, is vibrating and moving ever so slightly. That movement means that it has kinetic energy. Okay, if I were to heat the room up, this kinetic energy would increase. Things would start to vibrate and move ever so much faster. If I were to decrease the temperature, they start to slow down, vibrate less. According to that idea, there should be a temperature that I decrease it all the way to where all motion would stop. We call that temperature absolute zero. That's the temperature at which all motion will stop. Now the temperature absolute zero, we call that zero Kelvin. Okay, so absolute zero is a concept. The temperature scale Kelvin would be zero at that temperature. Now, earlier I mentioned the size of 1 degree Celsius. When they developed the Kelvin scale, they decided that 1 Kelvin is the same size as 1 degree Celsius. That makes it easy because when we get on to converting things, we're actually going to see that converting from Kelvin to Celsius and back is very, very straightforward. Not so much with Fahrenheit. Fahrenheit is also defined based on water. However, he's got these seemingly strange values. So 32 degrees Fahrenheit for the melting point and 212 degrees Fahrenheit for the boiling point. There are reasons why these temperatures are what they are, but we're not going to get into that in this video. We're not discussing the history and the development, so to speak, more so the application here of these three temperatures. So let's look at three different thermometers, all representing different scales. We have Kelvin on the left, Celsius in the middle, Fahrenheit on the right. We have up top the boiling point and condensation point of water. We have the melting point, freezing point of water here. Below that, all the way down here is absolute zero. Absolute zero is going to be represented by zero Kelvin, okay, just like we mentioned earlier. Now we do know from the slide that we have melting point of water, 0 degrees Celsius. The boiling point is 100 degrees Celsius. Okay, let's see what happens next. We do know, you don't, but you do now, that Kelvin is 273 degrees higher than that of Celsius. Okay, so if that's true, that means Celsius is 273 less than Kelvin. So coming down here, we're going to look at absolute zero in Celsius. Celsius is 273 less. So that means you have negative 273 because it's 273 less than zero. So that means a negative value. Come up here, looking at the melting point of water in Kelvin, we're going to have 273 because it's 273 higher than that of Celsius. Continuing with the pattern, this should be easy to figure out now. What's 273 plus 100? 373. Okay, these two convert very easily. You can use this formula anytime you want. It's a simple conversion. Celsius is 273 less than Kelvin. Kelvin is 273 higher than that of Celsius. Easy peasy. Now, Fahrenheit is one that doesn't play along too well. This is the one that he's a troublemaker. He doesn't follow the rules. According to the slide, we do know that there's 32 degrees Fahrenheit for the melting slash freezing point. We also know that it's 212 for the boiling point. Okay. There is almost seemingly no connection between these temperatures here and these temperatures here. So to convert from one to the other actually involves getting out a graphing calculator or making a graph on paper and finding the y-intercept form of the line. Don't worry about that right now. That's not what this video is about. I'm going to give you the formula. Formula is degrees Fahrenheit equals the degrees Celsius times 9 over 5 plus 32. So that means whatever value you have, you plug into this formula and you solve for the one you're missing. So if you have Celsius, you plug it in here and you solve for Fahrenheit. Now, that means if we were to use this formula, we can come down here and find the absolute zero of Fahrenheit. Right there, negative 459 degrees Fahrenheit. Okay, one more thing to notice is that there's only two formulas here. You have one from Fahrenheit to Celsius. You can use algebra to rearrange it if need be. And we have one from Kelvin to Celsius. Again, use algebra. But we do not have a formula from Fahrenheit to Kelvin. Okay, now my students, I don't ask them to memorize how to do that. There is a formula to go from Fahrenheit to Kelvin, but I don't really necessarily see a point to that. You can memorize it, but that would be on you. You would have to look it up and everything. But for me, I look at it this way. If I have two formulas and I can find out what Fahrenheit is, convert that to Celsius, then convert that to Kelvin. I do have a link from one to the other using only two formulas. So I only memorized two formulas. There's the third, like I said, but I don't ask my students to know it. I just ask them to use these two and go from there. Now, one thing to notice, if you look over here, this is the lowest possible temperature. This is the lowest possible temperature, and same thing here. These two can be negative. This cannot be negative. You will never see negative Kelvin. Kelvin is very streamlined and is based on zero. It's based on energy, and it's based on the kinetic energy. So you can never have anything less than zero energy. You can never have anything less than absolute zero. It's absolute zero. It's the lowest it can go. But for Celsius and Fahrenheit, you'll see negative temperatures all the time. Now, what I would like you to do, little example problem, I want you to use this formula here for Fahrenheit to Celsius. I'm going to give you a temperature. You're going to pause the video, and you're going to try it. And then there's going to be an awkward pause while you're staring at the screen waiting for me to come back. Okay. The temperature I'm going to give you is negative 40 degrees Fahrenheit. Negative 40 degrees Fahrenheit. Solve for Celsius. So you're going to have to do some algebra and rearrange. You're going to pause the video. I'm going to stop recording for a moment, and we're going to come back. Okay, hopefully you actually solved for that, and you paused the video and everything. I'm kind of stalling here to give you a chance to click the pause button if you haven't already. So again, the question was negative 40 degrees Fahrenheit. What is that in Celsius? Now, if you did the work and you did it correctly, you might be surprised to find out that negative 40 degrees Fahrenheit is equal to negative 40 degrees Celsius. It's the only temperature at which they match. Negative 40 degrees Fahrenheit is the same as negative 40 degrees Celsius. So that could be a question that I like to put on my quizzes and tests to kind of see if my students are going to get tricked by something like that. They might look at that and try and figure out how they get 40 and 40. But it's possible, according to the formula, that's what it is, and that's the conversion that works. Well, I'd like to thank my new subscribers and viewers for checking out my channel. I really appreciate you guys watching my videos. Channel's been doing pretty good lately. I can be found on Twitter at Getting Junk Done. And if you like the video, please like, comment, share, and subscribe. Thanks for watching.